HelpHippo helps support the Hippocratic Oath. Our previous epidemiology tutorial covered sensitivity and specificity. This tutorial will cover positive and negative predictive value. First, you have a patient, then you have a test, and then you decide on a course of action. Sensitivity and specificity is for deciding which test you should choose next. Should I use a sensitive test that can sense when I'm just a little bit sad, or a specific test that specifies my sadness only when there is strong evidence that I'm really sad? You use sensitivity and specificity before taking the test, when you're deciding which test to use next. To test if I'm pregnant, should I use a cheap but sensitive test that's on sale because it's near its expiration date, or should I spend more for a fresh test with greater specificity and less false positives? You worry about positive and negative predictive values after taking the test. It's too late to worry about money and sensitivity after I've peed on that stick. Once the test says I'm pregnant and I'm deciding how much to panic or celebrate, that is when I use positive and negative predictive value. Pause and review. All four calculations are just percentages. Positive predictive value is the number of true positives over the number of all positive test results. So, if you have 5 true positives and 5 false positives, your positive predictive value is 50%. But if you have 999 true positives and 1 false positive, then you've got a good positive predictive value. Negative predictive value is the number of true negatives over the number of all negative test results. Positive and negative predictive values are calculated similarly. Pause and review. While the denominator of positive and negative predictive values are total number of test results, the denominator for sensitivity and specificity are total number of people. Sensitivity, like positive predictive value, has true positives on top. But while positive predictive value has all positive test results on bottom, the denominator for sensitivity has total number of people who are genuinely positive for the disease. Specificity, like negative predictive value, has true negatives on top. While negative predictive value has all negative test results on bottom, specificity has all people who are genuinely negative for the disease on bottom. It's easy to remember these calculations because the true value always rises to the top. You never have a false positive or false negative in the numerator. Also, predictive value sounds boring and clinical, so it sounds like it should have the total number of test results on the bottom. And sensitive and specific sounds like it can apply to people, so it sounds like it should have the total number of people on the bottom. Pause and review. See our epidemiology playlist for more biostatistics videos, and visit helphippo.com for more tutorial videos and flashcards. HelpHippo, help support the Hippocratic Oath.